bacteria culture, starting with 200 bacteria, grows at a rate proportional to its size. After 3 hours, there will be 900 bacteria. This is an example of an exponential growth. This is an example of an exponential growth model. So we'll be using the function p of t equals p sub 0 times e raised to the power of kt to model this situation, where p sub 0 is a starting population, k is the exponential growth rate, t is the time in hours, and p of t would be the population after t hours. We first want to express the population after t hours as a function of t. Then we want to find the population after 6 hours. Then we want to know when the population will reach 5,000. So let's start by finding the exponential function that will model the bacteria population. We're starting with 200 bacteria, which means p sub 0 is equal to 200. And then after 3 hours, there will be 900 bacteria. So when t equals 3, the population, or p of t, is going to be equal to 900. We're going to sub these values into our exponential function and then solve for k, the exponential growth rate. So we want to solve the equation 900 equals 200 times e raised to the power of k times t, but t is 3, so we have e raised to the power of 3k. And now to solve this exponential function, we'll start by isolating the exponential part, or e raised to the power of 3k, so we'll divide both sides by 200. This simplifies to 1. 900 divided by 200 is 4.5. So we have 4.5 equals e raised to the power of 3k. And now to solve for k, we're going to take the natural log of both sides of the equation. After doing this, we can apply the power property of logarithms and move this 3k to the front of the natural log. So now we have the equation natural log 4.5 equals 3k times natural log e. But remember, natural log is log base e, so we have natural log or log base e of e. And since e to the first power is equal to e, again, remember, in exponential form, we work our way around the equal sign, e to the first equals e. This simplifies to 1. Multiplying by 1 doesn't change anything, so we just have the equation natural log 4.5 equals 3k. So to solve for k, we divide both sides by 3. This quotient will give us our exponential growth rate. So now we'll go to the calculator. Natural log 4.5 divided by 3. Now, the more decimal places we use, the more accurate our answer is going to be. So we'll use 6 decimal places. So it's going to be approximately 0.501359. And now that we have our exponential growth rate, we know our exponential model. It's going to be p of t equals the initial population of 200 times e raised to the power of kt. And now we know the value of k, so it's going to be 0.501359 times t, where t is the time in hours. So let's take this function back to the previous screen and answer the next two questions. So if we want to know the population after 6 hours, we want to find p of 6, or substitute 6 for t. So p of 6 would be the population after 6 hours. So we have 200 times e raised to the power of 0.501359 times 6. So now we'll go back to the calculator and type in the right side of our function. If we press second natural log, that brings up e raised to the power of, and the exponent is our exponential growth rate times 6. If we round to the nearest bacteria, this would round to 4,050 bacteria. And then for our last question, we want to know when the population is going to reach 5,000. Well, we can tell from the previous question, it's going to be more than 6 hours. So actually in this question, they're giving us P of t for our function. We want to solve for t. So we want to solve the equation 5,000 equals 200 times e raised to the power of 0.501359 t. And to solve this exponential function, we'll isolate the exponential part. So we'll start by dividing by 200. It simplifies to 1. 5,000 divided by 200 is equal to 25. We'll now take the natural log of both sides of the equation. And on the right side, we'll apply the power property of logarithms. So we'll move this exponent to the front. So now we'll have natural log 25 equals 0.501359t times natural log e. But remember, natural log e is equal to 1. So multiplying by 1 is not going to change the value of this. So we can simplify this out. So to solve for t, we'll divide both sides by this decimal coefficient. When it's on the right side, this simplifies to 1, so we just have t. And then we'll get a decimal approximation for this quotient. So we have natural log 25 divided by 0.501359. So we can see it's going to be approximately, let's say, 6.42 hours. And that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.